welcome people to Sliema. All my days, what a view. Look at that. I think this is the place where most people get their boats from, or their ferry from, to go to Gozo and certain parts of Malta. Okay, so Sliema. Sliema is a very, very popular place for tourists. If you don't come to Sliema, then you're missing out. Sliema, Valletta, St. Julian's, Gozo, those are the main places. I was actually thinking of going to other non-touristy destinations, but I don't know if I have enough time for that. Also, I was considering going to Sicily. If you watch my previous video, you'd see that I spoke to some Italian ladies, and she's from Sicily. I suppose they have a lot of people that come all the way from Italy to work in Malta. Sicily is actually very, very close to Malta, because Sicily is literally in the Mediterranean Sea, so it's easy for people to commute. You can easily catch a boat or a ferry and make your way down to Malta. Okay, so today I'm not going to buy any tickets, because I think I might just buy that online. It's just much more easier to get that online. I think the prices might vary though, but I'll check online. It's just much more easier for me, instead of going to people, asking them for the prices. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, she said, welcome to Malta. It's just much more easier for me to do that online. And also, it's better to do it online because they might not give you the tourist price. It will just be a general price for everyone, isn't it? So I might consider just doing it online. Also, that way I know I'm in control. Okay, the weather in Malta is lovely though. I swear to God, I thought it was going to be really cold, but it's actually very warm. I know I've said that so many times, isn't it? The weather is so good. So I would say there's no problems coming end of January, beginning of February, because the weather is okay. The people wearing a thick jacket are really suffering right now. I've seen a lot of people take it off because there's no point. It's so warm. However, you still need to bring a jacket though for the evening time. When it's around, let's say 6-ish, 7-ish, it starts to get a bit cooler. So you might need one, especially if you're hanging around where the water is. You might want to consider having a jacket on you, so that way you're not cold. But I don't think you really need it though, if you're in the restaurant. The weather is so good. All you need literally is a jumper. I think if you have a jumper, you'll be okay. So consider buying some jumpers if you don't have any. Especially if you're coming from a hot country, consider buying some jumpers. I've got many anyway, considering I live in the UK, so I've got to have jumpers. Okay, so what's available to do in Sliema? I would say there's a lot to do. So you can jump on the ferry, like I said. Let's see where all these boats go to. Okay, so I suppose this is like the map of Malta. So I suppose the boats go to these places. So you've got French Creek. That's a destination. Cospiaco, that's a destination. Vitoriosa, I'm pronouncing that all wrong though. The popular places obviously are places like Sliema Creek, which is probably the area I'm at the moment. Actually, I think this place is called Sliema Promenade, I think, if I'm correct. But yeah, so these are the destinations you can actually go to. There's St. Paul's Anglican Cathedral. That's quite popular. I'm going to make my way to Valletta today, actually. And probably again tomorrow. St. Paul's Bay, I'm thinking of going there. But I'll probably go there early tomorrow morning.
and go to Gozo on Saturday, sorry. So tomorrow is a Friday, so I might do an early one to St. Paul's Bay, then probably do Valletta's Sliema again and St. Julian's. Let's see. Like, I think there's still a lot I've not seen as of yet. Also, the Medina, they've got the Mdina, they call it. Not Medina. It's Mdina, I think it's called. Round Malta. Hey, you all right?
All right. Any information?
Yeah, yeah, that would be nice, actually.
All
right. I was wondering, so, in terms of prices, how much do you charge to Gozo?
To Gozo, I just told the guys that actually.
So what's your name anyway? So
my name is Thomas, nice to meet you.
Thomas, yeah?
Yes.
And your company is called Malta
Sightseeing. Actually, the name of the company is Supreme Travel.
Okay,
here. This is the name of the company, Supreme Travel.
Okay.
So, actually what we provide is a boat that leaves at 10:30 from Sliema. Goes directly to...
How do you pronounce it? Because I get it wrong. So it's Sliema, yeah?
Sliema. Sliema.
Yeah, I don't know, like, for some reason I call it Sliema.
It's like,
but
it's without the E, you write Sliema.
Sliema.
Sliema,
okay,
yes.
That's lovely, yeah. Cool. Yeah.
So we leave at 10:30 to go to Mjar Harbour.
Okay.
Once we arrive here, a double-decker bus, the green one, is going to pick us up and bring us to Victoria Rabat, which is the capital of Gozo.
Oh,
okay?
I see.
Once we arrive here, we will have 2 hours and a half time to visit the Grand Castle, the old prison. You can eat some traditional Maltese food. You have to figure out that Gozo and Malta has two different type of economy.
Oh yeah, that's what people say. So is Gozo cheaper? Or...
Yes, way more cheaper.
Okay.
I mean, there are some things that there are no difference, but if you want to have, for example, you want to rent a quad, okay, it's the half of the price.
Okay, so how much would it be to rent a quad in Gozo, for example?
When we went, 40 euros, quad, 40 euros per 7 hours.
Okay, that's not bad.
Very good.
For 7 hours?
Yes.
Wow.
For the whole day, it was like 50 euros for the whole day.
That is really cheap.
It was very good.
Yeah.
Yes, so once you stay here for the 2 hours, eat some traditional Maltese food and everything, we're going to bring you to Hala Point. Hala Point is a panoramic point where you can take some beautiful pictures and take Comino and also the island of Malta.
Okay.
Here we're going to take you we are going to stop for only 15 minutes, so you're going to take the pictures. After this 15 minutes, the bus is going to take you back to Mjar Harbour. From here, you're going to take the bus. The boat, who is going to take you to Blue Lagoon.
Okay,
so you're going to visit two in one.
Okay.
Okay.
So how much would that be roughly? Because like people keep asking me to find out how much it is. So for people that are interested in traveling, how much would that be altogether?
40 euros.
For 40 euros.
40 euros.
Return, yeah?
Yes.
So from here to there, then come back.
Exactly.
Yeah?
All included. Cool. And by the way, if your hotel is not here in Sliema, maybe your hotel is in Valletta, St. Julian's.
Yeah.
We have the transport included as
well. Oh my days. That's like VIP, isn't it? Like VIP treatment.
Exactly.
Okay, really good.
And the boat that we are using is the Delfini. It's this
Delfini,
one.
Yeah.
So you can also stay on the top.
Yeah.
You can see it, by the way, here. Yes, that one, the white one over there.
Okay. Oh, the white one.
The white one over there.
Oh, that one, yeah?
The one written Gozo, Comino and Blue Lagoon.
Okay, that's it. Oh, that's a big one, actually.
The big, really big one.
Wow, okay. So your company is called what again? Supreme Travel. So guys, when you come to Sliema, or if you're based in St. Julian's, anywhere you are, they could pick you up from there and take you to Gozo and the Blue Lagoon and bring you back for 40 euros, yeah? Make sure you speak to a guy called Thomas. He's a lovely guy, very, very kind, and he's willing to help you out. Okay, take care, yeah?
Take care as
well.
Cool. You want a brochure?
I don't mind, yeah. Thank you very much, yeah? Take care, guys, yeah?
I want to have your Instagram, wait a second.
Yeah, I'll give you my Instagram and my YouTube channel.
Yes, cool, man.
So I'm just going to give that to him, guys.
Ah, you're live now?
I'm not live.
From Instagram, I can find your YouTube channel?
Not necessarily. I'll give you my YouTube in a minute. So that's my Instagram. If you go to YouTube, I'll show you my channel. I'll post the video tomorrow, so you can see it tomorrow.
So you do this around?
Yeah, so I travel across the world literally.
Very nice.
Yeah, there's a lot of videos for you to watch anyway. I only just started recently.
Great, so there's a lot of videos. Wow.
So if you go, I'll show you. So I don't understand because this is Maltese, isn't it?
Or Italian.
So I've been to that's my playlist. I've been to all these countries. The best one so far is the Egypt one. I'll show you that one. That's doing very well. That one, 40k views. Doing really well. That one. So. Feel free to watch it, yeah?
Yes, of course. I know you how YouTube works, so, yeah, so no, I will. Yeah, I will help you.
Alright, cool. Alright, take care, guys. Take care. Bye. Okay, so, I've given in my YouTube channel, so I'm still gallivanting as usual, having a good time. Hopefully, I get something lovely to eat and drink. Oh, this is a nice restaurant. I don't know if it's Italian. Is this Italian or Maltese? This restaurant, is it Italian?
Italiano.
Italiano. Oh, I love. Are you Italian?
Yes.
What part of Italy?
South Italy.
Is it? Okay. You're not from Sicily, yeah?
No.
Where the mafia is?
No.
I'm joking.
Matteo.
Well, I love Italy though. I've been to Rome. I've been to. Florence, I've been to a lot of places in Italy.
Thank
actually.
You so much.
I love it. I love Italians.
Thank you.
Yeah, cool.
Italian
food. Oh, that's lovely food.
Yeah.
Okay, take care, guys. Yeah.
Bye bye.
Yeah. Yeah, there are a lot of Italians around. Italiano. You've got to love the Italians, man. They are so calm and easy to talk to. Okay, let's keep moving. So you can obviously speak to the vendors here to get a reasonable price to travel around Malta. Okay, so let me just educate you on something though. So you can either take a bus to Valletta, for example, or take a ferry. Hey! Oh, I thought you were saying hello to my people.
Hello, Hi. Guys.
Oh, yeah, you're all right.
Yeah.
Good.
How are you?
I'm good. You?
You're in Malta?
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. hi, you're right. Yeah, good. So you can either take a bus to Valletta or you could take a ferry to Valletta. So it depends on what you like anyway. There are many options, obviously. So it just depends on what you actually like. For me, I like the bus because that way, I don't know, there's something about it. It's like you kind of assimilate with locals. Like in the UK, I'm always driving. And obviously it makes sense for me to drive because I kind of know the locals, isn't it? I'm used to the whole system. But in Malta, I don't know no one. So jumping on the bus makes you understand how the locals work, how they think. Like for example, today, when I jumped on the bus, There was a Maltese guy next to me, and because of the way I was sitting, because I was trying to look at the screen, so that I don't miss my stop. So I kept looking at the screen, and he said, "Oh, are you okay?" He said, "Why can't you sit like opposite me?" Like he wanted me to sit next to him, like proper. And I'm like, "Oh no, it's okay." Because I'm a tourist, I just want to make sure I drop off at the right stop. The Maltese people are very, very friendly. They always want to make you feel welcome. That's one thing I've noticed. You'll see that from a lot of the locals, actually. Not to say that the expats here don't do that, but I think the locals are always happy when they see tourists around. It's something I've noticed. Even when I went to the shop to get myself some water, the locals were fantastic. Oh, it's amazing. Okay, I think this is a very popular shopping mall or center around this area. I think it's called The Point. So I might look for that later on today.
Oh, wait, it's you.
Let's see how my journey goes. Oh, I'm loving Malta. I don't know why people say Malta is boring though, because it's actually not boring. It's actually very interesting. Oh, look at some. That's some chips.
Tomato ketchup, curry ketchup, spicy.
They've got cheesy chips in that place. Cheesy chips. Oh, look at all of that, yeah. They've got little boats
this is a very nice scene, I swear to God. I wish you were here. Like, the weather is perfect as well, it's not too bad.
Earlier on, when I was talking about how warm the weather is and how I don't think you need a jacket, I heard some British couple at my back, obviously smiling, and I said, isn't it, yeah? So, because they're thinking, yeah, he's absolutely right, like, the weather is perfect.
Okie dokie, what's going on? So, it's not too busy per se. I suppose it gets much more busier in the evening because a lot of people finish work around that time and obviously they are looking for a place to relax, have a drink and to munch.
Oh, let me tell you a joke though. So I was at a bus station, yeah? And I'm not sure, he didn't sound like he was Maltese. He sounded much more like an expat that works in Malta. And he said, oh, you look so good. I was like, okay. Because he saw me taking a picture of myself. So he said, oh, you look so good. I was like, okay, yeah, you look good as well. And he said, okay. He said, oh, where are you going to? I said, Sliema. I pronounced it wrongly. He said, no, it's Sliema. Sliema. He said, between me and you, it's called Sliema. Oh, that was so funny.
Oh, this is a nice, nice place to go to, actually. Okay, so they sell sushi.
Yeah, so this place, I think is like a sushi bar.
So you can have some sushi and some nice drinks. It's actually a lot of places to go to. Let's see how expensive Sliema is compared to St. Julian's.
Apparently Gozo is really cheap, so I'm looking forward to that. I want to go there early actually, so I could explore Gozo properly.
Okay, so let's see how much their local beer is. That's how you could tell how expensive the area is, according to my Maltese friend that I met on the plane. I can't actually see where their beers are. Looks like they only have cocktails and things like that. Okay, okie dokie.
Let's keep going. But it looks quite pricey compared to other places I've seen. Hello. Yeah, so that's a nice place to go to, I suppose, whenever you come over.
Okay, so we're still walking around gallivanting, looking at beautiful Malta. I swear to God, I might come back to Malta, you know, like, the vibe is crazy. Oh, look at that giant hotel. Look, they've got like a swimming pool area. Very nice. I don't want to go in there, but it might be like, it might be like a restaurant within a hotel kind of thing. There are people swimming in there.
So the water must be nice and warm.
My hotel actually has a swimming pool, but I don't think it's a warm one. I don't think it's a heated one, that's the word. So I'm not going to bother. But I might ask them later on today just to reconfirm though. But I know when I checked online, they said it isn't... it isn't a warm one, that's what the reviews said, but who knows, it might be that they have a heated one now.
Okay, so we're still walking around gallivanting as usual.
So far so good. I would say the Maltese people are friendly, nice people. So if you want to consider moving to Malta, I would say yes to that.
I don't know if I can move to Malta though, because I don't speak the language. And I'm sure a lot of people that work here can speak some sort of Maltese. I'm not willing to learn Maltese at the moment. I'm still working on my Polish. That's priority.
When I finish learning Polish, then maybe I'll consider Maltese.
Okay guys, this is one part of Sliema I thought I should show you. I'm going to move on to other places to show you a bit more. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe. I know a lot of you like my videos, and please make sure you keep liking it. as in clicking the like button. That really helps my channel. Feel free to comment if you want to. All those commentaries actually help. The more you comment, the more YouTube would recommend my videos. And I'll catch you in my next video, guys. Take care. See you later.